A very good morning and Jai Hind children. Welcome to chemistry class. Children, yesterday we have started the revision of chapter combustion and flame. And today we will continue with this chapter, the revision of this chapter. And I'll also send you the worksheet. So after the class, please go through the worksheet and try to solve the questions. Okay? So there are a few extra questions that can come in your exam from within the chapter. Okay, so that is combustion and flame. So children, in the previous class, that was yesterday, we have revised till the extinguishing of fire. That is, we have talked about soda acid type fire extinguisher. So to just give it a quick recap. So soda acid type of fire extinguisher. So we have a container, a small bottle and a knob in the this soda acid type of fire extinguisher. And what happens then? The knob is stuck and the bottle is broken because the bottle is made up of glass and bottle is containing sulfuric acid and the container is containing sodium bicarbonate. So sodium bicarbonate is a soda and sulfuric acid is acid. That is why this fire extinguisher has been named soda acid fire extinguisher. Getting it? Here soda is sodium bicarbonate and acid is sulfuric acid. So that is why the name is given soda acid fire extinguisher. Okay? And which gas it liberates out? It liberates out carbon dioxide. And this carbon dioxide just create an envelope around the area where the fire is there and it seizes the fire. So that was fire extinguisher for you. So I can also show you few diagrams. And apart from soda acid type of fire extinguisher, we also have few more types of extinguishers. Like we have this is extinguishing the fire. We have talked about soda acid type of fire extinguisher. Apart from soda acid type of fire extinguisher, we also have dry powder fire extinguisher, foam spray, water and carbon dioxide is same, soda acid type. Okay. So, the same procedure is followed. The procedure is what? Pull the pin. We'll pull the pin. Aim at the base of the fire. Squeeze the level. This is a nozzle from where the gas will come out. Okay. Swipe side by side. So it will create an envelope around the fire and the supply of oxygen will be cut off. Okay. So that was fire extinguisher. Now today children, we will study and we will revise about flame. Okay. Children, we have seen flame, but everything that burns is not a flame. Okay, there is difference between burning and flame. So what is flame and what is burning? This we are going to differentiate. Okay, so to create a flame, a very important thing is the only substance that vaporizes burns with a flame. Jo bhi cheez vaporize hoti hai, that only can create flame. Okay, like you can see in a candle. Here, this lighted candle. This is a flame, but this burning of coal is not a flame. Okay, because that why it happens, this I will make you clear in a while. Okay, so today we are going to revise what is flame, what are the conditions necessary for the flame, and we'll also see the structure of candle flame. Okay, there are several levels and several layers in the candle flame, that is non-luminous, luminous, dark zone. So all these zones also we are going to study. Okay, so children, please open your book. Please open this topic flame. Now we are going to revise this topic flame. Okay, so flame, everything that burns is not a flame. Okay, so what is flame? Only the substances that vaporize burn with a flame. Okay, now what is flame? So children, when there is sufficient amount of oxygen present and it burns with a blue light. That is called flame. Okay, so kerosene rises up the wick of a stove and vaporizes before burning. The vapor burns with the flame. When the candle burns, hot molten wax rises up in the wick and vaporizes. So jitni bhi cheez vaporize ho rahi hai, be it a candle, be it a gas stove, all these things are considered as a flame. Okay, the burning of charcoal does not vaporize. The burning of coal, it does not gives a vapor, so it is not a flame. Getting it? ये आपने दोनों चीज देखी है, आपने कोल की बर्निंग भी देखी है, आपने कैंडल की बर्निंग भी देखी है, आपने गैस स्टोव भी देखा है. तो इन कैंडल देयर इज अ फ्लेम, इन गैस स्टोव देयर इज अ फ्लेम, बट इन केस ऑफ चारकोल और कोल व्हेन इट इज बर्निंग इट डज नॉट गिव्स फ्लेम, इट ओनली ग्लोज. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड, दैट इज नॉट अ फ्लेम, वेयर अ कैंडल एंड स्टोव इज अ फ्लेम. ओके, सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट हियर. When there is sufficient supply of oxygen, the substance burns completely, producing a non-luminous or blue flame. Now, the flame can also be of two types. First, it can be a blue flame, that is non-luminous zone, and it can be a yellow flame or a luminous zone. Okay. When there is sufficient supply of oxygen, then a blue colored flame appears and that is a non-luminous zone. Getting it? That is of blue color. I am again repeating it. Oxygen sufficient amount mein hai. Take for example a gas stove. Aap jaise gas jalate ho, blue flame comes from that stove. Okay? Why? Because there is sufficient supply of oxygen. जैसे जैसे हमारे सिलेंडर में एलपीजी धीरे धीरे खत्म होता जाता है, वैसे वैसे अगर आपने नोटिस किया हो तो द फ्लेम चेंजेस इट्स कलर टू अ येलोइश और अ पिंकिश कलर. ओके, दैट शोज दैट नाउ द गैस इज बिकमिंग लेस एंड देयर इज नॉट एनफ सप्लाई ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. दैट इज व्हाई द फ्लेम इज चेंजिंग इट्स कलर. ओके, when there is complete blue, the supply of oxygen is sufficient and the flame will be of blue color and which is non-luminous. Blue is non-luminous. Blue flame means non-luminous. Non-luminous means when there is sufficient supply of oxygen. Okay, like seen in LPG burn. Okay, however, in an insufficient supply of oxygen, a flame of yellow color is obtained. Okay, so that is why, like, yellow flame shows insufficient amount of oxygen, and in that case what happens, there is no vaporization. Yellow color appears because of the burning of carbon. Okay, because of the burning of carbon there, so that is why it is of yellow color. Okay, so flame of Bunsen burner, you can see here, I can show you the figure again. I can show you the diagram. So let me revise it once again. So in sufficient supply of oxygen, complete combustion takes place and non-luminous zone or a blue flame is obtained. During insufficient supply of oxygen, incomplete combustion takes place and yellow color appears. Okay? Yellow color is obtained because of glowing of unburnt carbon atoms. I hope you are clear with this point. Now let's see the flames. Children, see, when there is sufficient supply of oxygen, we get a blue flame. Slowly and gradually, as the supply of oxygen is decreasing, the color of flame is changing to yellow and then to a bright yellow color. Okay, so which is good? This yellow, this blue flame is good because it will not liberate any kind of carbon content, whereas this yellow flame will give out some carbon content that can be, when you are exposed to this unburnt carbon, it can cause certain breathing disease. Okay, so blue flame is due to the sufficient supply of oxygen and yellow flame is due to insufficient supply of oxygen. Okay, so this is the diagram of a Bunsen burner. Okay, in case of a sufficient supply of oxygen and in case when there is less amount of oxygen present. Okay, now coming back to the chapter. So this we have talked about. Now in this chapter, the very important topic is candle flame. So children, we all have seen a candle. Okay, so if you observe a candle very clearly, so this is a wax. What is this? This is wax, and you can see a black wick present over here. Yes, so as soon as you burn this wick, what happens? This wax gets vaporized, it gets melted, and with the help of wick, it rises up. Okay, hence the candle can be flamed, or candle can be burned. Now, when this candle is burning, it can have a various zones. Okay, in a candle, we can have various zones. The figure is not clear here. You can see it in your book. It must be clear. Okay, so there is a wax, okay, which act as a fuel, and fuel, we know, it contains hydrocarbon. Okay, then we have a wick, jo black color ki thread like structure, black to tab ho jata hai when we burn it, normally it is of white color. Okay, so that is a wick. So as soon as we burn the candle, the wax gets vaporized and the wax travels to the wick, and hence we can easily just burn the candle. Okay, so now when the candle is lit, we can observe various types of zones depending on the supply of oxygen. Okay, see, this is very obvious. Oxygen is present in the atmosphere, correct? Oxygen is present in atmosphere. तो जो आउटर लेयर होगी दैट विल गेट अ सफिशिएंट अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? ऑक्सीजन इज प्रेजेंट इन द आउटर एयर, आउटर एटमॉस्फेयर. सो द आउटर मोस्ट लेयर ऑफ द कैंडल विल गेट अ सफिशिएंट अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन, एंड हेंस व्हेन इट इज गेटिंग अ सफिशिएंट अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन, द कलर ऑफ फ्लेम विल बी ब्लू. And hence it is called non-luminous. Blue flame means non-luminous. So the outer portion is non-luminous and is of blue color. Okay. Now, move inside. Just a layer after the outer layer. That layer will have insufficient supply of oxygen, and the oxygen cannot reach there. And there is insufficient supply of oxygen, and hence the color of that middle layer of the candle flame will be of yellow color. And because it is yellow color, it will be luminous zone. What it will be? Luminous zone. Okay, so let's see. We have non-luminous zone, that is the outermost zone. This non-luminous is the outermost zone. Okay, the zone of complete combustion, because the oxygen is present in sufficient amount and the complete combustion takes place. And because the complete combustion is taking place, the lot of amount of heat will be released, and hence it is the hottest part. So children, the question can arise like, among these zones, which is the hottest zone? Okay, or the question can be like, arrange these layers according to, like, from outer to inner layer, arrange these layers. So sabse pehle aayega hamara non-luminous, then luminous, then dark, then blue zone. Okay, so that can be there. So what is the outermost zone? Outermost zone is non-luminous zone. Okay, so it is the outermost zone. Adequate supply of oxygen is present, hence there will be a complete combustion. However, it is very thin and may not be visible. At times it is not visible. Okay. Now coming on to the next layer, then we have a luminous zone, or zone of incomplete combustion. इनकम्प्लीट कम्बशन है, इसका मतलब क्या हुआ कि ऑक्सीजन की सप्लाई इनसफिशियंट है. ओके, एंड इफ देयर इज इनसफिशियंट सप्लाई ऑफ ऑक्सीजन देन द कलर विल बी येलो एंड कम्बशन विल बी इनकम्प्लीट. ओके, सो सी, इट इज अ मिडिल जोन ऑफ द फ्लेम. द वैक्स वेपर डू नॉट बर्न कम्प्लीटली एज द सप्लाई ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इज इनएडिक्वेट. The carbon particles produced because of incomplete combustion. We know that whenever there is an incomplete combustion, the unburnt carbon is produced. Okay? Giving this zone a bright yellow color, the flame leaves black soot on. Like whenever आपने कभी candle जलाई है and if you put something over it, ठीक है, तो क्या होगा? The black color will appear over the object. आप जिसके ऊपर कैंडल रख रहे हो किसी ऑब्जेक्ट के ऊपर, तो ब्लैक कलर विल अपीयर एंड दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द अनबर्न्ड कार्बन दैट इज रिलीज्ड ड्यूरिंग द इनकम्प्लीट कम्बशन ऑफ द मिडिल जोन. गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? ओके, सो दैट इज इनकम्प्लीट कम्बशन. नाउ मूविंग अहेड विद द नेक्स्ट जोन. सो आफ्टर ल्यूमिनस जोन वी हैव अ डार्क जोन, दैट इज द इनर मोस्ट जोन. ओके, then we have a dark zone. What is that dark zone? The dark zone is a zone of no combustion. सबसे पहले बहुत ज़्यादा combustion हुआ, फिर combustion कम हुआ, फिर combustion खत्म हो गया. Then there is no combustion. Okay? And if there is no combustion, there will be no heat released. जब combustion नहीं हो रहा है, तो heat release नहीं होगा, and hence it is least hot. And that is why at times when you play with the candle or aap jab candle pe aise se you just pass your fingers through the flame of candle, you don't feel the hotness. Okay, because you are passing your finger in the dark zone. Okay, upar upar rakhoge to you will feel the heat, and if you will put it in the dark zone, you will not feel the heat. Okay, so it is least hot. So question again can come from here, which is the least hot zone in the candle flame? So the answer will be dark zone. Okay, so children, many question can arise from this topic, that is candle flame. So read this topic very carefully. Okay, it is the innermost zone of the flame. See, non-luminous is the outermost zone, then we have a middle zone, then we have a innermost zone. ठीक है, that is a dark zone in the area surrounding the wick. Here the wax vapor do not come in contact with oxygen. Wax vapor do not come in contact with oxygen and hence do not burn. Okay, getting my point? And the last one here just near the wick is a blue zone again. Because it is very close to the wick, it has a sufficient amount of wax and hence it has a sufficient amount of oxygen. Okay, so in the small region at the base of the wick, here carbon monoxide is produced in the inner zone due to incomplete combustion with a blue color. Getting it? So this is the innermost layer. Okay, and in the innermost layer you can see a blue color. Getting it? So now let me show you the PPT again. Okay, so see, this is a candle flame. So in the outermost layer, if you see this candle flame very clearly, there is a yellow color, this blue color appears at the outermost layer. So hence it is the non-luminous or the outermost layer. Then we have this yellow zone. It is luminous zone and that is yellow in color. Then we have a no combustion zone. This is a no combustion zone. Okay, then in the innermost here again we have a blue color and it is the dark zone. Okay, so these are the layers: hottest, moderately hot, least hot. So this is the layer that you can see. Okay. So this was about the candle flame. This topic is, children, very, very, very important. So please read this topic very carefully. Okay. So candle flame is very important here. Now moving ahead with the next topic of this chapter, that is calorific value of a fuel or fuel efficiency. This is also, children, very important. See, whenever any combustible substance is burning, it is producing certain energy and certain heat, okay, and hence it is used as a fuel. Okay, we use it as a fuel, like petrol is used as a fuel, various gases are used, as hydrogen gas and everything, they are used as a fuel. Okay, why? Because it is producing a large amount of heat and energy. Okay, so all combustible substances liberate heat when they are burned. The amount of heat liberated when a unit mass of combustible substance burn is different for different substances. Okay, so this energy that is released is different for different substances. Okay, this determines whether or not the substance is a good fuel. We don't use all the substance as a fuel. We only use certain substances to be a good fuel. Okay, we refer to it as a calorific value. Okay, so what is calorific value? Calorific value of a fuel can be defined as the amount of heat liberated when 1 kilogram of a fuel is burned in sufficient supply of oxygen. Only 1 kg of fuel is burned in a sufficient supply of oxygen. That is called a calorific value of that substance. Okay, getting it? So what is calorific value? When the amount of heat that is released, take for example, we are taking 1 kg of any fuel. Okay, now that 1 kg of fuel, when it is burnt, it will release certain amount of heat or energy. That energy is called its calorific value. Okay, higher the calorific value, better is the fuel. Jiski calorific value jitni zyada hoti hai, wo fuel utna acha hota hai. Okay, so higher the calorific value, better is the fuel. So here are the list of fuels and their calorific value. So the best fuel here is hydrogen gas, having the highest calorific value. But we don't generally use the hydrogen gas. We cannot collect it. There are certain disadvantages for this hydrogen gas, and scientists are still working over it. But we are using methane as a gas. We are using LPG. We are using diesel. We are using petrol, kerosene, biogas, charcoal, coal, wood, cow dung cake. All these fuels we are using, they are having a respective calorific value. Getting it? So the nowadays the thing that we are using is methane, LPG. LPG is having a sufficient amount of a calorific value. Okay, it is 50,000. Okay, so among these, LPG is having a good calorific value, and hence it is a good fuel. Okay, so what is the SI unit of calorific value? The SI unit of calorific value is joule per kilogram. Okay, joule is represented as J, per we put a slash, and kg. Per means 1. Okay, 1 kilogram. See, energy, the unit of energy is joule. Okay, so it is joule per kg. That is, in 1 kg, how much amount of energy is liberated? That is joule per kg. This is the SI unit of calorific value. Though commonly the unit can be kilojoule per kilogram. Kg per kilogram is used. Okay. So scientists are working on using hydrogen as a fuel, as it has the highest calorific value, creates no pollution after burning. Some success has been achieved and hydrogen is expected to be fuel for the future. But nowadays, like now, we are not using hydrogen as a fuel, but it is the best fuel whenever it will be used, and hence it will not create any pollution also. LPG has a fairly high calorific value since it does not produce a smoke when it is burned, so it is preferred to for domestic use. So in the gas cylinder that we use in the kitchen, it is having a LPG. What is full form of LPG? It is liquefied petroleum gas. It is liberated from the fractional distillation of crude oil. Okay, and if you remember, it is having a how much carbon atom? Only 1 to 3 carbon atom. Okay, now petrol and diesel are used in transport sector. They are also having a fairly good calorific value here. Getting it? So this was about the calorific value. So what is calorific value? Whenever we are burning 1 kg of any substance and usko burn karne se jo heat release ho rahi hai, that is called its calorific value. What is the SI unit of calorific value? The SI unit of calorific value is joule per kg. Okay, but we generally use it as kilojoule per kilogram or kilojoule per kg. Getting it? Now, which among these is having the highest calorific value? So hydrogen is having the highest calorific value. But if the question is which among these is having the highest calorific value for domestic use, then you will write and you will tick on LPG. Getting it? That is liquefied petroleum gas. Okay, so that is about the petrol and diesel, and that is about the calorific value. Now, characteristic of a good fuel. This is also important. What are the different characteristics of a good fuel? How we will decide that which fuel is good? So here it is. The heat liberated by fuel is measured in kilojoule. Okay. So a fuel is considered good if it has a low ignition temperature. Now children, tell me, jiska low ignition temperature hai, wo jaldi burn karega or will it take some time to burn? Definitely, the substance having low ignition temperature will burn faster. Okay, so agar wo jaldi burn kar raha hai, so it is a good fuel. Okay, produces large quantity of heat. Definitely, we require a large quantity of heat for a good fuel. Okay, tabhi koi bhi engine or koi bhi process easily work karega jab usme sufficient or a high amount of heat liberate hogi. Okay, has a moderate rate of combustion. Moderate rate of combustion hona chahiye. Is safe to store, handle and transport. Do not cause pollution. Leave behind little or no residue after being burnt. Is cheap and easily available. Natural gas best meets all these conditions. Okay, so which among these is a natural gas? Methane is a natural gas. Okay, getting it? So these are the few good characteristics of a good fuel. Okay, now coming on to the types of fuel. So we have basically three types of fuels, that is solid fuel, liquid fuel and gaseous fuel. Children, here was the confusion about LPG. Children, LPG is stored in a liquid form, and when it is liberated out, it is liberated out in the form of a gas. So we consider it as a gaseous fuel. Okay, here I think LPG is written in a liquid fuel. It at times it is also considered, but we are mostly considering it under a gaseous fuel. So always remember, LPG is a gaseous fuel. Okay, now solid fuel like coal, cattle dung, cakes, baggers, sugarcane, all these are solid fuel. Liquid fuels are kerosene, petrol, diesel, all these are liquid fuel. Because petrol, diesel and kerosene and fuel oil, you see it in the liquid form. But LPG, we don't see it in a liquid form. Okay, it is present in the gaseous form. So we are considering it in here in a gaseous fuel. Okay, so LPG is considered as a gaseous fuel. Okay, so some gaseous fuels are natural gas, that is methane, coal gas, water gas, producer gas, biogas, acetylene, etc. So all these are gaseous fuels. LPG is also considered under gaseous fuel. Okay, now impact of burning fuels. What are the impacts of burning fuel? So if there is insufficient burning, like incomplete burning, the carbon can be liberated out, which can contain SPM, that is suspended particulate matter. So what is SPM? SPM are the small particles that can easily be seen, and it is a very, very small tiny particles that is suspended, a very fine particle that is suspended in any substance. Okay, so it is SPM, that is suspended particulate matter, that is containing carbon. Okay, and it is very dangerous. Now carbon dioxide, when it is liberated in a large amount, we know that it causes global warming, and I have clearly told you what is global warming and everything, so I'm not going into much detail of it. Now carbon monoxide, when there is insufficient supply of air, then carbon monoxide is released, and it is very deadly, toxic, and it can take the breath. Okay, it can cause death also. Sulfur dioxide released on burning can cause acid rain. So what is acid rain? So sulfur dioxide, when mixed with water, forms sulfuric acid. Okay, water, basically that is a rain water. Okay, because see, from any industry sulfur dioxide is released and it is accumulated in the atmosphere, and when there is a rain, it mixes with the sulfur dioxide and forms sulfuric acid. So I have explained all these things to you. Now oxides of nitrogen is liberated from vehicles, that is also very harmful. Lead compounds are also very harmful. Again, it is released from unleaded petrol and everything. Okay, now oil spills, dams construction causes the destruction in environment. Children, please go through this chapter. This chapter is very, very, very important. Okay, so please go through this chapter. You can understand it very clearly. So, and now children, I'm going to send you the worksheet. So after the class, please go through the worksheet. There are various questions, extra questions of this chapter. Please practice that. Okay, so that's all for today's class, children. Thank you, and Jai Hind, everyone.